Minh Le. He's Vietnamese and was born on June 27th, 1977. He is also responsible for creating one of the most popular games ever made to this day, Counter-Strike, commonly known as Gooseman, which was his online nickname by the community and fans alike. In fact, there was even a graffiti put into the game to commemorate him on the very popular map Dust 2, which read Goose. Minh Le was a video game programmer responsible for co-creating the later famous Half-Life mod Counter-Strike, alongside his friend Jess Cliff. He had originally created the game Counter-Strike as a mod from Valve's Half-Life and had intended for the game to be a small yet fun pastime for players to mess around in, made from the Half-Life engine named Gold Source, even though it is spelt as Gold SRC. And yes, this is a different engine than the famous Source engine, which was used in later games in the Counter-Strike series. Amazingly, he made the game while studying at Simon Fraser University in his spare time, and admits he actually spent more time making Counter-Strike than he spent on his schoolwork, although it seems that that paid off in the end. Nice one, Minh Le. The first hands-on experience in game creation and design that Minh Le had was using the level editor inside of the popular 1993 game, Doom. After that, he got to grips with what he described as the extremely tricky system and made his first map. Bear in mind that at this point in time, there was no YouTube or internet to help guide you with all this sort of stuff. You couldn't simply look up a tutorial on how to create games and maps. Minh Le noted how difficult it was to really learn Doom's level editor at the time, due to simply being stuck to figure it out on your own. But once he got the hang of it and created his first map, he states that he knew that he wanted to do this type of thing for a career and make a living out of it, which inspired him to start working on creating the mod, Counter-Strike. So, he began work on the mod. Luckily for Minh Le, a majority of the work for the game had already been done due to the game being created as a mod for Half-Life. For instance, the networking and graphic rendering was already done, which Minh Le states was a great benefit as it saved him a ton of time and work. This was a saving grace due to the game being developed by just two people, Min and Jess, so they did not have a huge company or team behind them to help aid with those sections of the game. In the very first version of the game ever released, there were only 6 guns, 2 maps, and 2 different player models, one for the whole counter-terrorist team and terrorist team respectively. Min stated that these two character models caused a lot of problems at the time, due to the models being so incredibly similar to each other that many players would get the CTs and the terrorists mixed up and end up shooting the wrong people. This is all very different compared to what we now have in CSGO, with the game currently containing 34 guns, 12 bomb defusal maps alone, and that's without accounting for the other game mode maps, and a plethora of different player models for each counter-terrorist and terrorist alike. It's crazy how things change. Min, alongside his co-creator, kept releasing new and improved versions of the mod. Meanwhile, the popularity for the game kept on growing with each subsequent release. Around the time that Min had released the 5th official version of Counter-Strike, he was contacted by Valve, the company that owned the game Half-Life, and the game which Min had created Counter-Strike from. Valve were impressed with the game and offered to purchase it from Minh Le and co-creator Jess, an offer they graciously accepted. However, both Min and Jess were still involved with the game Counter-Strike, as both of them were subsequently hired by Valve themselves to help aid the game's future creation and give insight on what needed to be tweaked or added in future installments. Though Min accepted Valve's offer to purchase Counter-Strike and the game's rights at the time, he now says that he regrets doing so for the amount of money he did at the time. He states that if he could go back in time, he would have asked Valve for a lot more money than he received. However, Min did not know at the time how big Counter-Strike would go on to become, as he never foresaw it rising to such popularity that exists in the present day. He was also 21 at the time, and a broke and poor college student, thus making Valve's offer all the more appealing, so it's hard to blame him in all honesty. And even though Min feels this way, he is not mad or upset at Valve. He respects the company a great deal, claiming that they taught him a massive amount about game development. One could also argue that had a big company like Valve not brought the game, maybe it would not have had the right support and knowledge behind it to become as big as it is. But this is something we will never be able to know for sure. Min was heavily inspired by action movies while creating Counter-Strike. Movies such as Rambo and Predator influenced the game, and Min wanted to create a game that captured those intense action moments that such movies possessed, making the players feel the pressure and adrenaline while they play. I'm sure this is reflected in the bomb defusal game mode, as defending a bombsite from a rush of terrorists, or rushing to defuse the bomb before the bomb timer goes off, gives players those exact same feelings. Other key elements for Min were that the game was kept simple and accessible to all players, so anyone could pick it up and play. There was also a strong focus on map design specifically, which was very much needed, as the popular bomb defusal game mode required balanced and even maps. The bombs needed to be correctly placed so that it was fair for both teams, as well as the terrorists and CTs receiving enough adequate cover and flank routes without letting either side become too overpowered. Many maps for Counter-Strike were also fan-made and submitted, making it into the game upon the community's approval. Even today, we see some of the most popular Counter-Strike maps still being played are fan-created. Min believes that the simplicity and accessibility of the game for all types of players, and the fact that the Counter-Strike fanbase was so passionate and driven while producing new content for the game, are the reasons it has become as popular as it is today. He said in a 2016 interview when asked if there was anything he wanted to add into the game, that he does not believe anything should be added, and that the game is perfect the way it is right now. Some interesting facts I learned while conducting research for this video was that Min actually strongly disliked the map Dust upon his first initial reactions, going on to call the map ugly and even protesting for its removal from the game entirely. Little did he know that Dust would go on to become one of the most popular maps in Counter-Strike history, as well as leading on to the map's sequel, Dust 2, hands down the most popular and well-known map in gaming history today. So it was a good thing the map was kept in. Min also admits that he did not think the game was that great when he first created it, going on to state that the game got extremely lucky by being released at the right time in history and at a point where no other game was quite like it. He believes this to be one of the main reasons the game got so popular. So what is Min doing now? Well, at one point in time, he was working on developing Counter-Strike 2. However, this project was put onto the shelf by Valve indefinitely. After Valve shelved Counter-Strike 2, Min left Valve to pursue his own project. He moved to South Korea and began working with a company named Fix Korea to release his own personal game, called Tactical Intervention. The game was very, very similar to Counter-Strike in many aspects, however, was not received well and was considered a flop, with even Min himself claiming the game was a failure. He blamed this on biting off more than he could chew, having a small team, poor testing of the game, and the fact that the game was far too pay-to-win and unbalanced. Since Tactical Intervention, he has worked on the popular game Rust, mainly helping with the game's animations. However, he stopped working on Rust in February 2018, and has now joined a new company called Pearl Abyss to work on a new project. And so, that is the story of Min Lee so far. A man who is responsible for one of the greatest games of our generation. Though he has left Counter-Strike for many years, his input will never be forgotten and will always be remembered. That's all for now, folks, and remember, Suka Bleed!